Welcome back, Dhanesh again from learnguitaronline.in. And as you know, in this series of lessons, we have been covering the top mistakes that beginner to intermediate guitarists make, which make them struggle on the instrument and slow down their progress considerably, and which I want you to avoid at any cost. If you have not watched the first lesson in the series, then I highly recommend you go back and watch that. That will give you an overview of what we are doing in these short lesson series. Now, like I said, these lessons are not going to be about playing exercises or stuff like that, which everybody talks to you about. Everybody tells you, do this much practice, do that, do this, do that, get your fingers moving, build flexibility, dexterity, strength, and all that kind of stuff. I know all that is out there for you, and these are part of my lessons also in a more methodical way. But, in these series of lessons, I don't want to give you all that talk. Instead, I want to talk to you about the things that probably you are ignoring at this stage, which is stopping you from becoming the guitar player that you want. So let's talk about the top mistake, the number one mistake that I see guitar players make. And I see this all the time with most beginner students that come to me first time when I interact with them. This is commonly found in, I would say, at least 98% of the beginners who have tried learning. So I'm not talking about people who have never tried learning. These are people who come to me and ask for lessons, and they have already tried learning. Maybe they are taking lessons elsewhere. Maybe they have tried learning by themselves. So what is the top mistake that you need to avoid at this stage of your learning? And that is to avoid cookie cutter lessons. What do I mean by cookie cutter lessons? Now, when you start learning guitar, everybody feels that everybody has to do the same thing to become the guitarist that they have imagined themselves to be. And that's, if you follow any sport, then it's like saying, if you follow cricket, it's like saying that everybody wants to become a batsman, or everybody wants to become a bowler, or all people in the team need to be wicket keepers. It doesn't work that way. Okay, if you know what you have achieved in your life, then you know that you have never gone by this philosophy. Unless, somebody forced you to do things in your life, you always had a choice to make about what you want to be. And similarly, when you get started with guitar, you have to make this choice. Even if you are not sure about it, you need to at least have some kind of vision in your mind about playing guitar. So when you get started, typically this is how everybody gets started, most of them. I want to learn guitar. I want to learn guitar. I want to do something in my free time. Some people tell me that you should always learn a musical instrument. You should learn music. Music relaxes you. These are the general feelings that people have when they get started with the guitar. Now, my first question to you is always, to every beginner to intermediate student, what do you want to do after you start learning guitar? Let's say we start learning and you're out of this beginner to intermediate phase in the first few lessons. Where do you want to go next? And this is a very important question that you need to answer for yourself. So stop doing all your mindless exercises and practicing. Put the guitar down. Take 5 minutes to think through. If you want, write this down somewhere. Ask yourself, how do you see yourself as a guitar player? Do you want to play pop songs on the guitar and sing along with that? Do you want to join a band? Do you want to form your own band? What kind of music is that band going to play? What kind of other genres of music do you want to learn? Do you want to learn rock music, blues, jazz, whatever it is? You need to have this thing in your mind first. And that is what's going to decide how quickly are you going to make progress on the instrument. Because if you don't have a clear goal in your mind, it's highly difficult for you to reach anywhere. You'll be going in all possible directions and getting stuck and then feeling frustrated, eventually letting you quit the instrument. So that's what you need to avoid. So tip number one is stop looking at what everybody else is doing. Find out what you have to do to get to where you want to be. And in case if you're having difficulty with that, come to me, book a trial lesson. I will help you with that. I've been doing that with all beginner to intermediate students. And the trial lesson is completely free. book one now and know what your real goal is with guitar playing. I'll see you in the next lesson.